happy Advent. It's not quite Christmas yet, but we're getting there. It's coming close. Our gospel lesson for today comes from the book of Luke. It's one of my favorite stories in the Bible. This man named Simeon. If you'd like to follow along with this story, you can find it on page 833 in your Pew Bible. Scripture says, "Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, looking forward to the consolation of Israel. And the Holy Spirit rested on him. It had been revealed to Simeon by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death, he would not die, until he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Guided by the Spirit, Simeon came into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what was customary under the law, Simeon took Jesus in his arms and praised God and said, 'Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all people, a light to reveal you to the Gentiles and for glory to your people Israel.'" Here ends the reading. I love this story of Simeon. There's also a story about Anna, close by. These two faithful people that were waiting for something to change. It feels really familiar to me, right? This story of these two that waited and waited because they knew that something was going to be different. They had this experience that was life-changing for them. So have you ever had an experience that was life-changing for you? Something that happened, someone you met, and you knew that nothing would ever be the same. So that happens in good and bad ways, right? But usually, it's really full of emotions. You just know, right? Anybody ever have one they'd be willing to share? I know they're usually pretty personal, but if somebody would be bold and brave to share, what was a life-changing moment for you? After her husband had passed away, she was watching Pastor on TV, and he said, "Is there someone in heaven because of you?" And she knew that her husband was in heaven, and it must have been kind of like a thing to do. But life changed a lot. Maybe I'm so much changing than I do. What was his name? You got to meet him. What a gift. Life changing, not Praise God, right? Praise God. Any other life-changing moments in your life? They're amazing, right? They're amazing moments. They're big moments and small moments. You know, how you decide which school to go to. How you decide where to have lunch. Right? Who you bump into, whether you turn right or left, the birth of a child. I mean, all of these things can be life-changing. They're poignant and powerful. Our lessons for today have some of those moments in them. Certainly for Simeon, here as he's waiting at the temple and Jesus shows up. And he knows that he is seeing the salvation of the world. Can you imagine? I can't. Our Old Testament lesson that I would love for you to check out is from Ezra. The people of God have been thrown out of the land. Their temple and city and world has been destroyed. And they spend all of this time in exile. And finally, the people that overthrew them are overthrown and they're allowed to go back into their homeland to the ruins. And they start to rebuild the temple. And as those foundation stones are laid and the people of God see the progress of the work being done, they weep and shout out in joy. All at the same time. Because they are seeing with their own eyes the promise being fulfilled. Now, I have never been forcibly removed from my home. I've never had my place of worship torn down to the ground. I can't imagine what that would be like. But I know it was a poignant and powerful moment. And they saw God at work in their lives, in that seeing is believing, I guess, right? Is that what we've all been told? We've maybe heard that before. Our experience kind of bears that out most of the time. It's easier for me to believe things I can see right in my face. It's clear. It's right there. Our reading shows several different examples of people seeing God in action in their lives. And all they can do is explode in exuberant praise and emotion. I'm a little bit disappointed with the version of the song that we get to read this morning, because in my Bible, every period is an exclamation point. I feel like exclamation points are underneath in the world. And when they're supposed to be there, I want them to be there. Praise the Lord! This is not just passive. This is exuberant. This is jump out of your skin kind of stuff. And you know that he has seen salvation as soon as he gets up in the baby. And he comes out in where everything is all bold and capitalized to make it better than expectation. That's how big this is, right? Seeing is believing. What is it? The thing that keeps grabbing me about all this certainty, all this seeing, is the question for me, is it that they know what they're seeing just because they're seeing it? Or do they recognize what they're seeing because of what they believe? Does that make sense? Is it seeing and believing, or is it because we believe we can see? The people of God in Israel had seen how God had moved in and through their lives, and I think they might have been more able to recognize what was going on in the rebuilding of the temple because of their prior experience. Because they had seen God show up. Because they knew what that looked like. Precisely because they were expecting it, it was more evident. Because it was so evident what can you do but jump up and down and sing in praise to God for the amazing, beautiful glory all around you. Seeing God at work in this world. And because they knew it, their praise was more free. Simeon believed that God was going to show him salvation. And because of that belief, when Jesus showed up, and his soul poured out in delight and praise for this promise that he had seen fulfilled. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him from the heights. Praise him, all his angels. Praise him, all his hosts. For my eyes have seen your salvation. Maybe it isn't that seeing is believing, but that believing is seeing. So here's the hard thing. If all of that is true, then we need to ask the question, what do you believe? Do you believe that God is active in your life and in your world around you? Is that a part of your experience? And there are no right answers here. It's just a yes or no. Right? It's a yes or no. If your answer is yes, great. I'm glad. Because if that's true, then I think it'll be easier for you to see God continuing to be at work in your life. To be able to notice when God shows up with love and forgiveness and grace. That's awesome. It's so great. Your answer is maybe or no. I would say, I get it. There have been times in my life when my answer has been no too. Hard when you don't feel like God is there. It can be very lonely. If your answer is no, what I might encourage you to do or recommend would be to find somebody who is a yes. Invite them out for coffee. Spend some time. Tell them what's going on in your life. Tell them where your hurts are. Tell them what your hopes are. And maybe that person who is a guest might, and I say might, be able to see some things in a way that maybe you haven't. To see how God is working in and through that situation. And if nothing else, just to find support. To let you know that even though you may not feel it right now, God really does love you, and God really is for you. And even if you can't see them, to God, and I can. And I believe that God is with you and with you. I think that's important work that we get to do for one another, because of this, I believe, truth. The things that we look for is what we find. If we're looking for God to show up, we're a lot more likely to notice when God shows up. And if we're too overwhelmed to look, then we need to call in back. Because we're not alone in this, friends. And when we do hit those moments where we see God doing amazing and big things, what can we do but all that exclamation point, thanks be to God. If God is here and doing stuff, what can you do but praise the God that is with us no matter where we are, no matter what we do, that loves us unconditionally. So this week, friends, as we continue in this time of waiting, in this time of searching with ourselves, and waiting for the light of the Lord, Emmanuel, God with us. Invite you to ask that question of yourself. Am I a yes? Do I believe that God is really going to show up and do stuff in what's going on with me? And do I need to call in from God? Friends, if you're a yes that's here right now, and you're thinking of someone that might be a no, I invite you to offer the same to them. Invite them out to coffee. Listen to them story. See if you can help them reframe what's going on here. That is with you. May you see God active in your mind and in your heart.